VertexCover and IndependentSet are polynomial time equivalent. So VertexCover reduces to IndependentSet using a polynomial time cap reduction, and IndependentSet polynomial time cap reduces to VertexCover. You may already be familiar with the idea behind these reductions, but if you're not, here's how it works. First of all, let's formalize the two problems. So the IndependentSet problem has as an input a graph g and an integer k. And the question is whether there exists a subset of the vertices of the graph, let's say this is subset S, such that the size of the subset is at least k. And for each edge, at most one of its endpoints is in the set S. So we would like to select a large number of the vertices of the graph in such a way that no two vertices in our selection are connected by an edge. So here's an example. This is a simple graph, and an independent set in this graph would be this. This would be an independent set of size 6. And this graph does not have an independent set of size 7. So if we choose the value k as being equal to 6, then the answer for this decision question would be yes. And if we choose 7, then the answer would be no. The problem VertexCover is as follows. We are given a graph g and an integer k. And the question is there a subset of the vertices such that there are no more than k vertices in that subset, and for each edge in the graph, at least one of its endpoints is in the subset S. So here is an example again. In fact, it's the same graph that we used as an example for independent set. And if we set the value k to 4, the answer is yes. So we can find a vertex cover of size at most 4. It's indicated here. And we can check that indeed each edge has at least one endpoint selected. Some edges even have both endpoints selected. But there is no vertex cover of size 3 or smaller. And this is not so easy to see, but it's true. The reduction between those two problems in both directions relies on the fact that these problems are actually very closely related. If we have a set of the vertices, a subset of the vertices S, that is an independent set, then if we take the complement of that set, V minus S, then that is a vertex cover. And of course, if a set S is a vertex cover, then the complement of that set is an independent set. So this establishes the relationship between a vertex cover and the independent set. If we just have an independent set, we then take all the vertices that we didn't select for our independent set, and that must be a vertex cover. To see this, suppose S is an independent set. Then consider an arbitrary edge, uv, in the graph. Since S is an independent set, at most one of the endpoints, so either u or v, can be contained in S. Hence, either u is not an S, or v is not an S. But that means that either u is in the complement of S, or v is in the complement of S. And therefore, the complement of S has at least one of the endpoints of this edge. And this argument works for any edge in the graph. And therefore, the complement of S is a vertex cover, because that's exactly the property we needed for a vertex cover. So for the opposite direction, assume that we have some set that is a vertex cover. Then consider any two vertices that are not in the set, but in the complement of the set. Say vertex u and vertex v. So u and v are not in S, but both of them are in the complement of S. Now, since S is a vertex cover, That means that UV cannot be an edge in the graph, because otherwise that edge would not be covered, because none of the two endpoints are in the set S. And therefore, any pair of vertices in the complement of S are not connected by an edge. And therefore, the complement of S is indeed an independent set by the definition of what an independent set is. So this means that if the graph G has an independent set S of size at least K, it also has a vertex cover, the complement of S, of size at most size of V minus K, and vice versa. This gives us our reduction. The inputs for the vertex cover and the independent set problems are of the form G, a graph G, and a number K. We can now define a polynomial time computable function that takes G and K and produces the same graph G, but replaces K by the size of the vertex set of the graph minus K. And now, because of the above relationship between independent sets and vertex covers, we have that G and K are an independent set if and only if the transformed input, which is G and size of V minus K, is a vertex cover. And of course, the reverse is also true. So if G and K are in vertex cover, then and only then F of G and K, which is G and size of V minus K, is an independent set. And this is exactly what we needed to prove for these carp reductions. Lastly, we also note that this reduction can be computed in polynomial time. In fact, we didn't need to do anything for the graph. We can just leave the graph as it is. And the only thing we need to do is we need to check how many vertices there are in the graph and then subtract k from that. And clearly, this can be done efficiently.